Can you please just kiss me the way you used to? I begged, and tried not to hate myself for the desperation in my voice. I don't know why the words had to spill out now, the worst possible time. Cassidy, baby, I'm sorry, but I've gotta go, Brian said, caressing his phone like it was the lover I used to be, pointing his toes away from me and towards the door. I just want you to kiss me like you mean it again, I whispered, trying to sound light and flirty and sexy, trying to ignore the panicked thunder of my heart in my chest, trying to ignore the voice in my head screaming that he didn't really love me no matter what he said, that after just 9 months together, he was getting bored of me already, that I was losing him before our relationship had even really begun. Honk! We both jumped as the Uber driver leaned on his horn. Cassie, I love you so much, but I can't miss my flight. And then his hands were on my hips, and his strong arms pulled me against him, and every cell in my body yearned for him to kiss me like he used to when I was exciting and new for him, like I was the only woman in the world for him, like he wanted me and only me forever. Love you, honey. I'll see you in a week and we'll talk about this, he said, and gave me a dry, boring, lifeless peck on the lips like he was kissing his grandma. And then he was gone, and I was alone with my terrible thoughts and a sense of growing doom in my heart. That night, I lay in bed feeling worthless and unattractive and lonely and scared, tossing and turning and listening to myself cry, wondering what had gone so wrong. I glanced at the picture of us I kept as the background on my phone and felt like I was punched in the gut, because I saw the look of absolute adoration on his face that made me feel cherished and loved and certain, the look I barely recognize now, because he hadn't looked at me like that in months. The look I was terrified he would be giving some other woman right now because she was young and pretty and new. When we first got together, we'd made out like movie stars. I always felt so soft and small and feminine and safe in his arms. I'd feel a deep primal growl in his chest every time he kissed me, and I knew he loved me and knew he was the one with no doubt at all. We'd even secretly laugh at friends who said the passion had died in their relationship because we knew we were special. We knew we were meant for each other, and that could never happen to us. But now, love you, honey, and sex when we had time. I lay there burying my face in my tear-stained pillow, feeling like a fool for thinking this time would be different. I thought about how I looked in the mirror, how men didn't stare the same way anymore, how long it had taken to meet a good man like Brian in the first place, after my heart had been broken so many times in the past by losers and scammers and guys who just wanted sex. I thought of Brian thousands of miles away, giving other women the look he was only supposed to give me. And in that moment, I knew I was at an important crossroads in my life. I knew I had to do something. And the more I thought about it, the more I realized I had just three options. One, I could pretend this was just normal, that this happened to everybody. I could give myself to this man and just accept that you could have passion or companionship, but not both. Two, I could end things with Brian. I could tear my heart to shreds and get back on the endless dating treadmill, put myself through the emotional brutality of dating today, risk ending up alone again, or with someone I didn't love half as much as Brian. Or I could make the choice I did. The scary choice. The brave choice. The choice to discover the truth about what passion and chemistry and spark actually mean to men, and why it's very different than what it means to us women. The truth about why men seem to lose interest in you after a while, no matter how hot you are or how hard you try to keep his attention on you. The truth about how to keep the desire and connection in your relationship, whether you're together for 2 weeks or 40 years. The completely irrational truth that leaves so many women lonely and sad instead of being loved by a man forever the way you deserve. I had a week before Brian got back.